Okay, YouTubers, continuing from yesterday, had a little problem with this because I was hammered it and everything, kind of mushroomed it out. So what I did is I ground it down until it could go ahead and accept. This part again. Okay, so I went ahead and fixed that part. And this part here had a little bit of mushrooming out too. So I was able to go ahead and get some, sandpaper, just go ahead and bring it down a little bit. Now that's able to fit over again. Okay, so here we have my three main parts of the engine, and also the crankshaft, and here's the piston. Now, it's all been cleaned out as best I can. You know, it's not perfect, but everything. The bearings are in good shape. The seals are in good shape too. And inside here, and it's all nice and clean. There's no any gouges or anything like that. I've already cleaned out all the surfaces right here to make it nice and neat. I've already made up a couple of gaskets and stuff to put it together. I used gasket paper. This is the paper. You can go ahead and it comes in in a roll and everything. You can get this over at AutoZone or Checkers or something like that for about like $5-6. Not too bad. No, $8. Actually, $8 went up a little bit. And it's called gasket paper. This is what I make these gaskets out of. The reason why I don't buy gaskets from the dealership and stuff is because they have these gaskets, really, really thin gaskets that I don't believe really help much anyway. See, this is the gasket from the middle, and this is mine that I made. You'll see at least mine is at least 1 or 2 millimeters thick. This is paper thin, about, I don't know, really thin, and I don't think it'll work anymore. Also, what I like to do is I like to go ahead and put a little bit of silicone, black silicone on it. This will go ahead and it'll keep seal it up really good. So I'm gonna go ahead and start doing that. Put on a little bit of sealant here. Yeah, there we go. Try as best you can to put it on there. You can't really do perfect, but there you go. So we do the other side here, just a little bit of silicone. So just put on just a very thin coat on here. This will heat. This will go ahead and like glue it together and make it so that it's very nice, you know. And it, and the oil and gas won't penetrate it. It'll go ahead and go out. I'll go ahead and let the bolts here drop together. Usually these can just go ahead, just go together real quick, easy, but for some reason there's a little bit of something in here that's not letting it move. Probably rust. Go ahead and put this back on. We'll go ahead and tighten it down really good. There we go. Perfect. Little notch here. Okay. Okay. So, I went ahead and cut the paper. I think it was a little too long. I cut the gasket a little too long. But there we go. Here we go. Now. So, this way. Okay, so. The cylinder's going to be on like that. Because here's your intake. Here's where your ignition coil goes. And the exhaust goes right here. And on this little piston, you can see a little arrow. And this little arrow goes pointed to the exhaust. So it has to be like that. And okay, so I got my little thing here. I got there's two spacers that go in here. Putting in the spacers is a little bit tough to do, but with enough patience and just very delicately, you can do it. It takes a little time, but it's possible. There we go. Where'd it go? Okay. Now, what we have now are the little clips. Just want to go ahead and a little groove in the piston that you want to put it in. And these clips and everything help to keep the roller in so it doesn't come out. Keeps it all together. There we go. Now the clips will pop in right into some grooves in there. So make sure they go in there like that. Okay. Oh, you gotta be kidding. You gotta be kidding me. How did I get it backwards? Oh man. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Now you're probably asking why, you know, why it's so important that this this piston is positioned a certain way. Well, the reason why is it's made a certain way so this exhaust or anything is that where the rings are on here, that they'll be in the way that they will not get into the little into the passageways and break off. So it really needs to be in a certain way. Very carefully put it back on. Okay. So there we have. So what it is that where they're on the gaps and stuff is that they will not interfere with the spaces in here. And they'll go right here and right here. So we'll not, because if it's another way and then it's going to go ahead and interfere with the gaps, the springs will come out a little bit and it's going to go ahead and break. And you're going to have broken rings, and that's not good for the machine. So I'm going to go ahead and put on.